I will make you exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of you, and kings shall come forth from you. And I will establish my covenant between me and you and your descendants after you throughout their generation for an everlasting covenant to be God to you and to your descendants after you. And I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land of your sojournings, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession. And I will be their God. And God said to Abraham, as for you, you shall keep my covenant, you and your descendants after you throughout their generations. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Response against Psalm. Your response. The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Consider the Lord and his strength. Constantly seek his face. Remember the wonders he has done, his miracles, the judgments he spoke. Your response.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
O children of Abraham, his servant, O sons of the Jacob he chose, he, the Lord, is our God. His judgments prevail in all the earth. Your response.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers his covenant forever, his promise for 1,000 generations, the covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac. Your response?
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Gospel acclamation.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
Now is the acceptable time. Now is the day of salvation.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
Long be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews said to him, now we know that you have a demon. Abraham died, as did the prophets. And you say, if anyone keeps my word, he will never taste death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who died? And the prophets died? Who do you claim to be? Jesus answered, if I glorify myself, my glory is nothing. It is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say that is your God. But you have not known him. I know him. If I said I do not know him, I should be a liar like you. But I do know him and keep his word. Your father Abraham rejoiced that he was to see my day. He saw it and was glad. The Jews then said to him, you are not yet 50 years old, and have you seen Abraham? Jesus said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, before Abraham was I, was I am. So they took up stones to throw him, but Jesus hid himself and went out of the temple. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, the reading just now heard, both the readings, demands from us faith. Faith in the living Word of God. You know, the Word of God contained in the Scriptures. When we read Scripture, God is speaking to us. With all love and devotion, you must read the Scripture, then only it is profitable. Yes, Scripture is a love letter from our Heavenly Father, brought by Jesus our brother. So, we must read the Scripture as we read the love letter. We know how we read the love letter, without attention, devotion, oh my, without looking this and that side. The same way, when we read the Holy Scripture, we read them as the love letter of our Heavenly Father, brought by Jesus our brother. Yes, this love letter contains the very Word of God. Jesus speaks to us through these Holy Scriptures. Yes. Secondly, we need faith in our daily life too. Unless we have faith and trust in our brothers and sisters and our parents, we cannot live peacefully. We quarrel left and right. Our house became a hell. You know, there is no peace. Because we don't trust each other. We have to trust one another. That is very, very important to live peacefully at home or wherever we are. Yes, secondly, we need faith whatever we eat, whatever or the water we drink or the medicine we take. Unless we have faith in these things, we will not get well or our hunger will not be ceased or the thirst will not be okay. We must have faith whenever we take these things. Yes. The first reading is now the faith of Abraham. It is so strong. He believed in the love of the Word of God. Totally, completely believed that God is able to do whatever He said, whatever He promised. And that God did do it. It is realized during the time of Abraham, even today. God told him, I will make you great. I will make you father of many nations, not one or two, many nations. And your posterity will increase generation after generation. It cannot be counted. And from your posterity, there will be so many kings and prophets. Yes, it is true. It will be realized that during the time of Abraham, even today, but the final prophet is Jesus. God sent Jesus through the posterity or the generation started, or the nations, the great nations started from the faith of Abraham. Yes, Abraham believed whatever God said it. And even today we see that we Christians are spread all over the world, all over the world and nations, because we believe that we have come through the faith of Abraham. We believe that he is our ancestor. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, we really receive the faith in baptism and during Christ. That we should develop it every day. How? By listening or reading the Word of God, by listening sermons, reading good books written by good authors, holy authors. By this, our faith is developed day by day. Yes. The Scripture we see, Jesus told the Jews straight away, unless you believe in my words, you will die in your sins. Because Jesus knew his origin. He has come from his Father. Father sent him for a purpose, not simply. The purpose is the redemption of the whole world. It was totally went away from him because of the sin of our first parents. And to recover from this sins, Jesus came in this world and our welcoming brought from his Father love and forgiveness. During the whole life, he distributed the love and forgiveness to everybody without any distinction, good or bad, of sinners or lepers or his own enemies. But what he got back? His own people nailed him on the tree. But from the tree he loved it. From the tree he prayed for it. From the tree he prayed for his people to forgive us. That's what Jesus did from the cross. That way meditate during the holy season of Lent. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, faith in our Heavenly Father, faith in the words of Jesus, faith in our own religion is a must to live a life pleasing to God. During the holy season of Lent, reflect upon the sufferings of Jesus. We are responsible for their great suffering. Now we have to pay back. How? By loving Jesus and also making a very good confession, honest and sincere confession. By this we can repay in a certain way the love which Jesus showered all of us. May God give us this grace and strength and courage to march forward to live our Christian or religious commitment well.
Come to the Lord. Come join us in this offering. Come to the Lord. Come with us as we go. Come to the Lord. This bread and wine we'll offer him. Bread for his body. Wine to be his blood. He's a
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given out for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from this. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Francis and Claire, and all your saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be choirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven,
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, at your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, we see the Lamb of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are invited for this banquet of love.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Take this, all of you, eat of this my flesh. Take this is my blood, shed for sinners all. For my life I give, and my love I share. Trust and believe in me. I am the resurrection. I am the bread of life. One who has faith and glory will live forever. Take this, all of you, eat of this my flesh. Take this is my blood, shed for sinners all. For my life I give, and my love I share. Trust and believe in me.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by the same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hail, Holy Cross of our Savior. Hail, Holy Cross of Christ. On His bleeding shoulder, Jesus bore you with love. Hail, Holy Cross of our Savior. Sign of redemption and love. We sing the glory, the power of your name through the Savior's blood.